कहीं न कहीं ये ठेकेदार की और अधिकारियों के गलती के कारण ये घटना घटी है।
High level corruption in Banaras also you suspended some low level officers. What about the accountability of the high level officers, the NH and the people, the minister who's in charge?
कठोर से कठोर कार्रवाई की जाएगी, बट हम लोग की प्रायोरिटी ये है कि हम जो है जितने भी इंजर्ड है उनको इलाज दिला दें।
Good evening. You are with Nation Now. I'm Seher Zama. We are looking at yet another collapse of an under construction flyover in Uttar Pradesh. Four people in this accident reportedly injured. Two are feared trapped. Rescue operations as we speak are still underway. But this isn't the first case. Very, very recently, in May this year itself, there was a collapse in the same state of Uttar Pradesh in a prominent constituency in Varanasi. The Chief Minister of UP, Yogi Adityanath, promised all safety guidelines for all under construction projects henceforth. But what has happened today? Is human life taken far too lightly by our leaders? A compromise in quality, a compromise in our safety to respect tight deadlines instead. We're going to try to get some answers to this yet another tragedy here. We have with us Ms. Anila Singh, spokesperson of the BJP, Mr. Abdul Hafiz Gandhi, spokesperson of the SP, the Samajwadi Party, with us, Mr. Yogesh Mishra, senior journalist, and Mr. Vineet Narayan, anti-corruption crusader. We've just got a very brief statement here from the UP Chief Minister, not even a statement, just information that he's ordered for an inquiry. He's wanting rescue operations to be completed at the earliest. But given that this was under the Union Road Transport Ministry, this was under the National Highways Authority of India, we still haven't heard from our Union Minister. Let's try to understand what's really happening here. Mr. Vineet Narayan, in your view, are we looking at a frequent looking away, a frequent lackadaisical response as far as people's safety is concerned here?
You see, problem is that the attitude towards hiring contractor, getting the plans made and execution has not changed over decades. Governments may come and go, parties may come and go, each one shout against each other saying they were corrupt and we'll be honest, but nothing changes. You know how the contracts are awarded despite Central Vigilance Commission's guideline of transparent process of tendering. Online bidding and all technical bidding and financial bidding, all that drama goes on. But practically what happens is that the contractors with money and influence approach the concerned minister at his home and office. The deal is stuck there. The advance in huge sum is paid to the minister or to his agent. And then the entire process is engineered in such a manner that the same person gets the contract. Once you have paid heavily through your nose to the minister to get that contract, you know, it's natural that you will compromise on quality and efficiency and aesthetics and everything. But what happens when the accident takes place, whether it is a collapse of bridge in Varanasi or collapse in Basti or sinking of roads, the entire blame is put on the engineers. Well, definitely engineers, right from JE to chief engineer, everybody gets their cut. But the thing is that the whole thing begins with a wrong footing, where corruption begins in giving contract.
Mr. Yogesh Mishra, senior journalist with us. Mr. Mishra, in your view, is there a sense that as far as these ambitious tight deadlines that have been set by a concerned authority, be it the state government, be it the union ministry in this particular case, we've had the minister several times give out statements flaunting in the number of record kilometers of construction that has taken place, a 20% hike in the construction in this financial year as to what happened last year. Is there a sense that the government here is at this breakneck pace to set a record, to flaunt these numbers?
I do agree with
irrespective of how the job is done on ground.
I do agree with Mr. Narayan. First of all, we should think over it that Mr. Minister is claiming only the road kilometer built by the NHI, but he is not claiming the quality and rest things of the road structures or things. Look at the other side of the picture. Bridges constructed during the British period still stand solidly even after more than 100 years. Why this contrast? Clearly, we should mention, each and every person should mention and understand the things. The answer may be simplified in blaming rampant corruption, which result in the use of the substandard materials, faulty design and very low level of workmanship. Added to this, this is the only problem. This is not caring by the minister, not the government.
Let's get in a word here from the SP, the Samajwadi Party, Mr. Abdul Hafiz Gandhi with us. Mr. Gandhi, you would be quick to blame the state government today and the central government today, but it's not as if construction that has happened, undertaken by your government in the past, has managed to stand the test of time. We just had the Lucknow Expressway cave in these mild rains in August this year itself.
As far as Lucknow Expressway is concerned, that was the matter of the service lane, and service lane was also maintained by the brother of the VGP mayor of Agra, and this government has awarded him for doing fine
work. Whom was it
so
constructed
I think that
by?
Most of the blame goes to the state
Mr. Gandhi,
government.
Whom
now,
was it constructed by?
No, the we constructed Agra Expressway, but the service lane was constructed by the brother or the company owned by the brother of the mayor of the Agra, and he was also awarded by this government, BJP government, for doing fine work. Now let me come to these two incidents, Banaras and the Basti. Now these two incidents, they show that the human life has no value for the government. I think that in the Banaras incident, the PWD minister Mr. Maurya made the statement that we will form the bridge safety cell. Now I want to ask, where is that bridge safety the cell of the government? As far as the Banaras bridge collapse is concerned, we do not know still the contracting company to whom the contractor was given. The ire fell on certain engineers, certain the small officers. Now the attitude of the government is also shown by the fact that Rajan Mittal, who was the MD of the State Bridge Corporation, we removed him for corruption charges. When we were running the government in UP, we removed him. And this government, when this government came in 2017, they reinstated the officer Rajan Mittal, whom we removed.
Right.
So
he
this
was
is the attitude of the government. This government is not for zero tolerance for corruption. This government reinstated. This VGP government reinstated him. And then when this Banaras bridge collapse happened, they again removed him. So we removed him during our tenure for corruption charges. So this is the attitude of the government. This is the attitude of the government which talks of zero tolerance for corruption. Now, as far as this Basti incident is concerned, 60% of the work has already been done. Now, NHAI is responsible and their engineers are responsible for supervising this. Now, they failed in their duty. Now, every time smaller officers and smaller engineers, they are made the scapegoat. No bigger up is held responsible for that. In Banaras, PWD minister was not asked for his resignation. We asked for his resignation, but certain officers were removed and nothing happened.
Okay.
We lost 18 lives. We lost 18 lives
yes,
in Banaras.
Yes, 18 lives were lost
in the inquiries
May,
ordered,
and in this collapse that is taking place today,
and the words
four people
like
have
nobody
been
will
injured.
Be spared. All
let's
these,
let's get some of
said,
those answers. We have
happened.
Ms. Anila Singh of the BJP with us. Appreciate you being with us, Anila. Several questions here being asked that this has happened, this is happening far too frequently, or this has happened far too fast. Because in recent memory, a collapse that took place in May, which cost 18 lives, several assurances that had come in. Chief Minister of UP had also said certain guidelines are going to be followed now and henceforth, strictly followed in all under construction works. But we're seeing yet another collapse.
Yeah, definitely. Like any collapse or any tragedy is a tragedy. And we just can't say that it is just a number. We do not want such numbers. We do not want such statistics. Definitely. There was an accident at truck, what we have gathered, the fact is that one truck crashed into that particular bridge which we are talking about in Basti, and perhaps there was a weakness in the structure, and or whatever the reasons are, because still probe is on, it collapsed. It shouldn't have, but it collapsed. But what was the reason behind it, and should it have been collapsed because of the truck accident, or it should not have? There are many questions, but the answers will be out once the investigation
is over. What happened in Banaras?
I would say something.
Gandhi sir, let me complete.
But Ms. Anila Singh, where we have construction going on, you have the area.
So let me complete. I'm just saying, I'm not denying the fact. See, I am saying that
you had, you should ideally have an area cordoned off.
As I told you,
if you have a track driving into an under construction site, where once and again we. Go ahead, Anila, complete your point.
Yes, like if we talk about the Varanasi incident, there also right action was taken, and like few of the officers, they were suspended, and the contractor, like he, his work was taken back. And in this case also, when the final report will come out that why this accident happened, and what was lacking, whether it was because of the bad quality of the construction or was it something else. So let us wait to get the final report in front of us. You know, it is very easy to attack government and blame the government. It is because of you that truck banged in that bridge which was under construction.
May I say something here?
It was because of you it collapsed. It is not like that. There are many reasons also.
I want to say something.
Mr. Vineet Narayan, this is a collapse that has happened earlier today. Yeah. Several hours have passed through, and the UP police has still not been able to establish any reason for this incident. Is something being withheld because of the backlash that the government would face then?
Well, I will not go on the merits of this particular case because I'm not aware of the facts, but I want to give you a very simple explanation for this kind of follies. I have been writing in my columns and telling chief ministers and ministers after minister, even to Mr. Yogi, I've told this twice, that there are two kinds of corruption in civil construction. One is corruption of implementation, and the other is corruption in design. Corruption in implementation, in India at least, is a universal phenomenon. Wherever you go in the country, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari and Assam to Gujarat, you will find cuts being shared by junior engineer to minister level everywhere, and there is a corruption in execution. But my concern is that corruption of design is much more severe than corruption in execution. That is when you hire consultants who are non-qualified, who are not competent, who come by, you know, flattery or by connection. They are not properly experienced. And then you unnecessarily inflate the cost of the project so much that you can make huge money out of it. So the finer nuances of the design are always compromised with. I want to give you a very simple example of last year. Last year, UP Tourism Department gave contract to some contractor, Lucknow, after the Yogi government came in power, for the restoration of 9 ancient water bodies in Mathura district. And the cost decided by the consultant, Bombay-based consultant, was 77 crore rupees. Since my organization, Braj Foundation, has done excellent work of Kund restoration, we have won 6 UNESCO awards. So we intervened and we talked to the minister and secretary, and they called us, and the consultants were called, and we had 7 hours meeting in Lucknow where we exposed the design. We exposed the design and the flaws in design. And you know what happened afterwards? The same Kund's restoration will now be done with 27 crore rupees. Thankfully, Yogi ji accepted our advice. But imagine from 77 crore to 27 crore. So 50 crores.
So you're helping us understand
the design, only
back channel talks, which eventually helped
to
which is the contractor that would come on board. But Mr. Yogesh Mishra, this is not any small time flyover in a small city. This is an undertaking of the NHAI, the National Highways Authority of India. One would think that there is zero room for error here.
Yeah, I do agree. National Highway Authority of India, roads is not very appropriate. If you will travel by the route in the rainy season, you will see the patches of the patches on the roads. First of all, I would like to question Ms. Amita ji, do you think only engineers are responsible in Varanasi? And if engineers are responsible, then I believe that your government is not ready to eradicate corruption, and if any other is responsible or responsible for the Aman Varanasi incident, then why not government has taken action, any big officer, any big contractor? I would like to answer from Amita ji.
Ms. Anila Singh, the sense is that the UP police is still investigating, that it's not been able to establish any reason. There is no information that is coming in. It's as if information is being withheld with great care. Otherwise, you would face a backlash. This was a collapse that happened early this morning.
Each and every person
knows
that
agree
the
with you
collapse in
when
Varanasi was the,
happen,
was the corruption. No.
You can't,
each and every
you can't
person
held
you,
any sort of
you can go through the
and
you
after,
can go through the UP
let's,
media.
Let's have Anila respond to that. Everything comes in front of you, because today it is our government. Tomorrow it might be somebody else's government. So you can't, you know, you can't hide the facts. Facts, you know, they can't be hidden.
How much
and
time
number two,
you?
Mishraji, my name is Anila
That's
Singh,
right.
not Amita.
Even if you look at the sequence of
if
you have a truck ramming into the under construction site there, this is once again a security lapse. Okay. But Anila Singh, even as you yourself stated, information that is coming out from the site of the accident, if you have a truck ramming into a pillar or of an under construction flyover, that in itself is indicative that you did not have the area cordoned off where construction was going on.
Saha, to tell you very frankly, even I do not know personally that whether this truck was from outside or was it carrying material for the construction of this bridge. So right now, even I do not have knowledge about it.
Okay.
So if this construction was for the this truck was for the construction purpose only, then the story is totally different. So that is why I said it is too early to comment or to give any judgment about it. We should wait for the investigative report to come out.
There is a very important political meet which is going on in Meerut. This is with respect to the ruling party. You have all the top leaders there of the BJP, including union ministers, including the chief minister. Would it have helped, Mr. Vineet Narayan, at this point, would it have helped if you had the chief minister at the site to send out a strong message, given that this is yet another collapse of an under construction flyover which has happened barely in a space of 3 months?
Well, I will again give you my practical experience and a micro example to explain the macro point. Recently, last year, the new government reconstituted the Braj Vikas Board for the development of Mathura Vrindavan region. When the constitution was drafted and I had submitted to the previous government, it was clear then we had kept provision for experts, landscape designer, architect, civil engineer, etc., etc. But when this new board was constituted by the government, they just got off all those experts' positions, and the whole power has been usurped in the hands of one vice chairman, one CEO. Now, if this is how you want to approach professional things, where you require professional input of various disciplines in civil engineering or architecture, structural, electrical, then this is the kind of mess you're going to face. You have to have professional approach, you have to have transparency, you have to have quality checks, you have to have quality controls. Nothing of that sort will happen, and only slogan shouting and ribbon cutting and tall claims if you keep making, whether this government or previous government, then people will suffer, and we are suffering for the last 71 years.
Mr. Abdul Hafiz Gandhi, it's important, it's easy
Sahar,
that
want
to completely be blaming.
Sahar, can I add one thing here?
Okay, sure, go ahead.
Okay, sir, I just
Should
want
I
to say one thing here about our government, whether in center or whether. Just give me 10 seconds, Gandhiji. Just give me 10 seconds. Sir, I just want to say that whether our government in center or in Uttar Pradesh, we do believe in transparency. And why I am saying so strongly is because we do e-tendering. We do not give tenders on some other basis, like earlier governments used to do. When we are doing e-tendering, it is totally transparent and we want business here. And if somebody is not ready to do business in a right way, then definitely our government is there in the center and in the states to check it out and to punish that company or the person as well.
Well,
Anila,
I told
when
you
speak
that
to us, you say you haven't
but
much information about
design,
this particular case. So it's being difficult to establish whether or not these guidelines were being followed or not. Anila, that assurance that came in from the Chief Minister in
that
following
is why,
all
that is why
safety
random,
security measures
sir,
in barricading.
Yeah, actually this
sure
project, if we are talking about Basti project, it is, like as you mentioned, it is under NHAI. And all the precautions should be taken by the contractors who have got this contract. All the safety measures should have been taken. And because of the laxity of their company, this incident has happened, this accident has happened, they have to face the heat. Nobody is going to protect them. We are not here
right.
to protect
so is
anybody.
Right, so is it just each time for the contractor to face the heat?
Business.
What about the respective authorities that have been instructed, by the Chief Minister to keep vigil? Abdul Hafiz, please respond. No, but you've only been naming the contractor. We're not looking at any heads rolling in the state government. Mr. Abdul Hafiz, please respond.
Actually, I could not hear your question. Can you repeat it?
Mr. Abdul Hafiz, on this premise that you have the Chief Minister giving out instructions since May that there will be strict vigil followed across all under construction sites. Apparently, that has not happened today.
All these are hollow assurances because we have seen in the past all these statements, we will not spare anybody, we will order the inquiry, nobody will be spared, etc. Now, we have seen in Banaras case how the pressure was being put from the PMO for the quick and early completion of the bridge so that it can be inaugurated before October or Diwali by the Prime
right.
Minister. And I am not saying this. Officers said this. And there were murmurs from the officers. They were saying that PMO is pressurizing them to complete the Banaras. And it is because of the pressure from the PMO that the workers were, you know, in a very quick to complete that bridge. So I think political angle is also there. This government wants credit for everything and they shirk responsibility for everything. Now murders are happening in jail, Devaria incident happened, now this bridge happened, Banaras happened. Now they will blame everything on the previous government.
And it is unfortunate.
Now
it is unfortunate that we still haven't heard from the concerned minister.
They are running this country for the last 4.5 years.
When a record is breaking, who is quick to flaunt figures here, but we still haven't heard from him. This is a collapse that took place early this morning. We still haven't heard from the Chief Minister either, but we know there is a very important political meet, a two-day executive meet of the party which is going on, and you have all the senior leadership there, but they are still sitting silent on yet another under construction flyover collapse which could have cost lives. Fortunately, there are no lives that have been lost today. 4 people injured, 2 are still trapped. Irrespective, it does not pardon your silence. We want better roads without doubt. We want better connectivity, but not over dead bodies of our own people. Why is our Union Road Transport Minister silent today? Will you only speak when there is a record-breaking number to quote and flaunt? Or is it more important to focus instead on a political meet which is focusing on elections 2019? That is the question. Where's the focus of our government? Appreciate all those voices here that have come in for Nation Now. Thanks for being with us.